Hello everybody and welcome to this new episode of our project Laravel Restaurants Management System. In the last episode we have displayed all the tables. Next we need to display. So we will display a tab navigation or a tab navigator, which will make us move between the categories, and inside each category we will display the menus belonging to that category. So let's start. So the first thing, we are going to add div with row and we will justify the contents into center. So next we have to add a column empty of 12 and we will give it a card class and a padding of 3. Next, inside this column we are going to use list group. This list group will take a class and class will be nav pills, and we give it a margin bottom of 3. Next, so this list needs an ID. The ID will be the pills tab and the role will be tab list. So it will be, as I said, we will use tabs to show the categories and their menus. Next we are going to loop through every category that we have already sent from the controller. And we display a list item with a class of nav item, and inside nav item we will have a link. This link will take a class of nav link. We will give it a margin right of 1, and inside this link there will be, we will display the category title. So let's check and see what we have done. So it takes some time, just we need to wait. So as you can see, we have here an error, undefined constant title. Where is the title? So here I have this error, just I forget to add the arrow. So let's check again and see what we have. So as you can see here down, we have all the menus here. So I want, when I click on one of these menus, so the I have here all the categories. So when I click on the category, for example breakfast menu, the menus belonging to the breakfast will collapse or display here. So that's what we are going to do next. So after we have the UL here or the list, we will add a div with tab content. This is the content of the of every tab, and we will give it an ID of pills tab content. And inside this one we will loop one more time through our categories, because to guess the meals, so we need, or the menus, we need the category, because already we have the relation between the category and the menu. So inside the for each we will add a class of tab 1, and this one will take the ID. The ID will be, so let's add the div first and then we add the ID. The ID will be the category, so we will give it the category slug, and we will give it a role of tab panel, and area Ja. Labeled by and we give it Bills tab. Bills you can add anything you want. I will make it tables. Bills home tab. Just the code I copied code from the Bootstrap. You can look for the tab navigation components, and if you don't want to write the HTML, you can copy it and put it here. Just change the contents as I am doing. So next we will add a row. Inside this row we will loop through the menus of each category. So we are going to use the relationship between the category and the menus, and here we have each menu. So next we will display the menus as I said before. So as I said before, we will display the menus. First of all, we will add a call of MD4 with margin bottom of 2, and this one inside this one we will have a card. This card will take the full height, so we will give it 100% of the height and of the height, and we will have another div with card body, and inside this one so we will give it the flex and flex column and justify contents into center and align items into center, align items into center. Next we will have another input like we have done with the table. So we will have inputs of checkbox. This one will take the menu ID, and it will be dry because we can choose more than one menu item. So I will give it ID of menu and value, and we will give it the value, and the value will be the menu ID. So every checkbox, the value of the checkbox will be the menu ID. So I forget to add, because this checkbox will be aligned as we have done with tables. It will be aligned to the end. So we will give. So we will add a div with a class of align self end, and we give it a margin bottom of 2. And here we add inputs field. So let's check and see what we have. So let's refresh the page and see what we have here. So as you can see, if I click on breakfast, so it will not show, because let's see what we have. So it's not showing yet because we did not add. So, or let me okay let's continue and see let's so we will let the demo to the end of the video. So just for now let's add all the contents to check better. So next we will add the image. The image will be inside folder which is images, inside folder which is menus, and it will take the menu image, and here for the can give it a title will be menu. You can give it menu title, and here we have a width of 100, width of 100 and height of 100, and we give it a class of MG fluid and rounded circle. So let's me add a class. Where is the tab constants? So this one, it has tab 1. I will add another class. Let me check just to see what I have here, because I forgot the classes. I will add active and fade, just to see if it will be displayed or not, just to check the constant. If not, we will continue and see, and later we will show, we will see demonstration. So as you can see here, I have the, if I click on some categories, but I don't see any results here, so it's not showing anything. Okay, I will check and see where is the error, and I will come back again. So I forgot to add here the data toggle to the menu to make the links related to the tabs, so I forgot to add them. So let's add them now. So here we will add data toggle. For the data toggle will be, as we have said, bill, and we will give this link an ID, and the ID will be the category slug, and we will add also href, which means the where the link will take us. So the link will take us to the category slug, so to the tab that has the category slug, because we have already added here, we have already given the tab, as you can see here, the ID, which is the category slug. So we are going to use this category slug, so we are going to use it to reach the tab. What else? So I think we can need just some more bootstrap attributes, like the role, we give it tab, and area controls, we give it category slug, and what is the area selected, and we give it true. So this is just bootstrap attributes. So let's move and see what we have. So if we refresh the page, let's refresh the page and see what we have now. So if I click on breakfast, so it is selected, as you can see, but the category menus is not displaying. So we have some I think that we have some menus here. Let me update the code. So I will go to the sale controller here, inside the creates method. Where is the creates method? So we will change the, so here we will bring just categories that has menus. If the category doesn't have menus, so we don't need to show it, as you can see, because if we don't have menus, so no need to show this category. So let's refresh the page and see what we have here. So now the categories are, the number of the categories are reduced. So if we click here, so as you can see, it doesn't show anything, but We have reduced the number of categories to just the ones that you have menus. I will pause again and see where is the error. So there was just some errors that I forgot, I didn't notice. The first one is to add class show to this tab pan, as you can see here. I forgot to add tab show. So you can add the tab show class to the div with class tab pan. And also here I had a typo. If you can see here, I had a typo here. I had dollar sign, so change this, remove the dollar sign. So that's all. So now we can see the menu. As you can see, if I click here, I think that it doesn't change, but at least we have the menu. As you can see here, it's showing here sandwich. If I click here, it doesn't change. I don't know what happened to, I have the same code that I have done before, but I don't know what happened to, don't know why it's not working. I have added the menu, as you can see here, the menu title. I have also, I think that's here. Here we have the column D4 and the margin bottom. I have here missing M, margin bottom of 4, and also here we have the card with the height 100 and the body with flex column. And I think that this is all. Just see what I will refresh the page. Also I forgot to see that for the image, now we are not showing the image from the assets, but because we have some random images, that's why the images are not showing. I will refresh the page. So as you can see now, the images will be shown. As you can see here, this is the images that they are already already in the database. But when I click on the other ones, it does not display the images. So as you can see, for the sandwich, if we use the assets, and the assets will take us to the image, I think that we have already added this folder inside the public function, the public folder. So I don't know what happened to me today. I think that I'm already tired, that's why I made such errors. I think that I will just record this one video and I will rest. So as you can see, we have already here folder images, and inside it's the menu. But I think that we don't need this one, because we have already all the path, it is already registered inside the image field. So let's check again and see what we have. So I think that this time it will show all the images, the default ones and the one that belongs to the sandwich. As you can see here, we have the sandwich and here we have the other ones. So I can choose from the menus here. I can choose, for example, two ones, and when I add order, so the order will take the two items that I have chosen. But I think that's something wrong, that's why it's not moving, it's not showing the pizzas, because I think that's all these categories, they have some menus, I will check again once more time and return. So I noticed that I have a typo. If you did not see it, I had already here href, another one here, so I removed this one. This one was wrong. And also we need to check. I will add this code. Here we are just checking if category slug is breakfast, so this is the link that will be activated. So first one that will be activated, so we will add it inside this nav link. So if, so we check for slug, if slug is equal to breakfast, so we add class which is active, so the first link will be activated. This line of code will prevent showing of all the menus, as you can see here. And also inside the here inside the tab pan we will add same thing. So if slug is equal to breakfast, we will add class active and show inside this one, inside tab pan, just to show just one menu. So this is the errors that I had and I didn't notice. So now, as you can see, we have the breakfast and we are just showing sandwich. If I click here, I can choose sandwich. If I move to the pizzas, it doesn't show the pizza. So I don't know what is the error again. So here I forgot here to add tab. So just add tab here, because the ID of the each tab must have the tab at the end. So let's check and see again what we have here. So I am going to end this video here, because really I am tired. So as you can see, we can choose sandwich. If I go to pizza, now it changes to the pizza italiano. If I move to the other ones, we can choose any menu that we want. So I am going to end this video here, because really I am tired. I will take some time to rest and I will come back again. Sorry for the errors. Next we will add form that make us add the new order. See you in the next episode.